with the articles that we had to put here on this text. Okay, we have a text about a source. A source are a set of islands in Portugal, in the Oceano Atlântico, the Atlantic Ocean. And so let's hear the recording. I think it's recording 4.
Português em ação. Os Açores são...
Can you hear it well? Can you hear the recording?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Yes.
Página 11. Português em ação. Os Açores são um conjunto de ilhas portuguesas, situadas no Oceano Atlântico, e estão divididas em três grupos: ocidental, central e o oriental. A ilha de São Miguel, no grupo oriental, é a maior ilha dos Açores. A paisagem natural é surpreendente e o clima ameno. Vale a pena fazer uma visita.
Okay, so this were the set of different articles, definidos e indefinidos, that we had to complete by listening to the text. So I will ask once again, is there any question about this text? Any question why do we use in some cases definidos and in other cases indefinidos? For example, here we have os Açores, so it's artigo definido masculino plural, okay? And then we have um conjunto de ilhas portuguesas, which is artigo indefinido masculino singular. Any question about this? About this text? I think his son has a question.
İhsan Bey, buyurun. Mikrofonu açtım.
Hola, professor. And in fact, mine is not a question, but a request. I couldn't find the audio files for that book. Could you possibly resend them?
Okay, after the class, yes. I will send a link again to Mariam, and she can please share in the group with you so you can download the audio files. Okay?
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Obrigada.
De nada. Mais alguma pergunta? Any further question about this? Okay, so let's pass to the other homework you had to do. This other homework was about the conjugation, the conjugação nova, the new conjugation we learned the last class, which is for present continuous, okay? The in Turkish you call it şimdiki zaman. So estar a mais infinitivo, the form that we use for to express actions we are doing right now or in this moment, okay? Agora ou neste momento. So we had two exercises. The first one was to complete the sentences with the verbs that you have in this box, okay? The verb brincar, which means to play, but used in the sense of children playing, okay? Because there are actually several different verbs in Portugal, actually not many, there are only three, to play. Okay, the first one is let's start with brincar. Brincar means to play, but it's used on the case of children. For example, in the sentence, as crianças brincam. Or let's use the same form, estão a brincar. Okay? The children are playing. As crianças estão a brincar. The other verb we have for play, oynamak in Turkish, is for musical instruments, or for a record or a CD that is playing. So, and in that case, the verb is tocar. For example, in the sentence, ele está a tocar guitarra, or ela está a tocar piano. And then, or if you want to express not someone playing an instrument, but a recording is playing, a CD, for example, a música está a tocar no leitor de vinil. Leitor de vinil means pickup, okay? A vinil recorder or player, okay? A música está a tocar. The music is playing. And the third one is jogar. Jogar is used for games, okay? Jogar, it's used for games, because the noun for games in Portuguese is jogos, okay? Games. And, for example, nós estamos a jogar ténis. Eles estão a jogar xadrez. Xadrez means satranj, okay? Chess. So, we have three verbs for play. Brincar, tocar, and jogar. All of them in English, it's they use play, to play, but in Portuguese we have three for different situations. Is there any question? I saw something on the chat. Of course, please make a question. Whoever has a question, you can make it now.
Mustafa Bey, buyurun. Şu an mikrofonunuz kapalı.
Professor, I can say a second.
Mustafa Bey, sesiniz çok kesik geliyor.
Yok. Şimdi iyi mi sesim?
Şimdi iyi.
Professor, I can say a second question.
Part C, of course, please.
Yes. Ana faz a los hoje a meia dela está a fazer bolo.
Yes, a mãe dela está a fazer bolo. Yes.
A fazer, yes.
Uh-huh. Muito bem, está correto. A mãe dela está a fazer bolo. Uh-huh. It's correct. It means her mother is making a cake. Okay? But since I have to pass to another thing today, I don't want to fill all of them. I mean, if you want to confirm your answers, you can check the answers at the end of the book. What I'm more interested is to ask you if you have any question about the exercise 4.1 or 4.2. I'm not going to do all of them now. I want to ask if you had any question, any problem, any difficulty, any doubt, whatever, curiosity, if you wonder about the meaning of a word, anything. Okay, so this is a time for you to ask. You can ask in English or you can ask in Turkish as well. Okay, so don't feel shy or something if you cannot speak very well English. You can also ask in Turkish. Okay, so please ask.
Soru sormak isteyenler İngilizce veya Türkçe sorabilir. Elemay Hanım buyurun.
I have a question about verb tomar. Can we use
tomar?
Eu estou tomar café. Like I'm having a coffee.
Precisely. Muito bem, Aidan. Eu estou a tomar. You can put eu or not, okay? It's like Turkish. You can say Ben or
Estou a tomar café.
Yes.
Like having coffee. Mm-hmm. I'm having coffee right now.
It's correct. It's correct. Okay, Aidan. You can use tomar to take, to have a coffee or to take a coffee, okay? But it's not used for all the situations in which you use the verb take in English, okay? For example, if you want to say, I am taking the metro or I am taking the bus, it's not this verb, okay? It's another verb that we use. It's apanhar, okay? To take a transportation. But transportation, yes. But if you want to say to have tomar, for example, to have breakfast, it's also this verb. Nós estamos a tomar o pequeno almoço. Okay? Breakfast in Portuguese is pequeno almoço. We are having breakfast. Okay? Or another situation is to have a shower. Okay? Estou a tomar duche. Okay? To have a shower.
Can you say tomar banho?
Yes, tomar banho. But then it's like tomar banho is. Estou a tomar banho. Having a bath, okay? Mm-hmm. Well, you can use it for the same situation, but literally, tomar banho means having a bath, okay? You can also say this word banho, you can also say for when you are having a swim in the sea. Okay, you can also say, for example, estamos a tomar banho no mar. Okay, it's also used for the sea. If you are on holidays in the beach and you go to the sea, you can also use it for that. Okay, having a bath in the sea, something like that. But it's definitely used for drinks. Okay, so. When you invite someone, for example, to have a coffee, the question is, queres tomar café? Wait, I need to change for just a second. Queres tomar café? Okay? Do you want to have a coffee? So this is the question you use. This is the verb you use for that question.
De nada.
Any more questions about the verbs of the exercises? If not, we will pass to the next section of today. And if you want to do a question later, you can also use the last part of the class, okay? So, just to close this part, what we have seen so far, we have seen verbo ser, verbo estar, the verbs to be in Portuguese, and we have seen this estar a mais infinitivo, which is the present continuous, okay? To express actions, we do now. But what about the Genish Zaman, the simple present, to express actions in general? And even you can use it to express the future. You can say, I have an exam tomorrow. So we are using the simple present to say an action in the future. What about those actions? Those actions are the verbs in presente do indicativo. Presente do indicativo basically means the simple present. And in Portuguese, we have mostly 90% or even more of the verbs end in ar, er, and ir. Okay? In terms of mastar, of infinitivo, they end in this ar, er, and ir. Okay? So three types of verbs. And we will see now the regular verbs, verbos regulares. So let's pass to page 12. I think some of you has your microphone connected, open. So if you please, if you are not going to speak, please turn it off, okay?
Sir, if it's okay, I will mute everyone, then I'll open your mic.
Okay, okay. Maybe.
Okay.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, so let's start with these verbos regulares, okay? As I said, there are three types, okay? Ar, er, and ir. And for all of them, in the case of regulares, in the case of the regular ones, we will see the irregulares, the irregular ones later. For the case of regulares, they end in the same way for the different pronouns. Eu, tu, ele, ela, você, nós, eles, elas, vocês. We already know this. They have, all of them, the same way of ending, okay? So what we do is, when we conjugate the verbos in ar, er, and ir, we take off the ar, er, and ir, and we add these terminations, which are regular for all of the regular verbs. So let's start by reading these different sentences. Let's go for verbs in ar. Eu estudo no Porto. I study in Porto. Tu falas português? Do you speak Portuguese? Ele, ela, or você mora cá? Do you live, does he or she live here? Okay, cá means here. Cá or aqui, okay? Cá and aqui, they have the same meaning. Nós trabalhamos aqui. We work here. Eles, elas, vocês jantam conosco. They, okay, have dinner. Jantar means both dinner and to have dinner. Jantar, dinner, and to have dinner. It's both a noun and a verb. Conosco means bizimle, okay? With us. They have dinner with us. So this is the case for the verbs in ar. They have these regular terminations according to the pronouns. O, as, a, amos, and am. Okay, for all of the verbs in ar, it's like this. For all of them, of course, the regular ones. Now, let's go for er and ir. The good news is that er and ir, they are exactly the same, with the exception of nós. In the case of nós, in ir is imos. In the case of er, it's emos. Okay, but all of them are the same. Let's see the examples in the book. Eu bebo muita água. I drink a lot of water. Okay? Muita or muito means chalk, okay? Very or a lot. Água means water. Tu conheces a Ana? Do you know Ana? Eu, ela, você come na cantina. He or she eats in the canteen. Comer, it's the verb for eat, for yemek. Yemek. Nós vivemos aqui perto. We live near here, ok? Nearby. Perto means yakın, near. Eles, elas, vocês, ok? So, they entendem, they understand mandarim, ok? Chinja, ok? Mandarim, or Chinese, the language. Let's go to ir. Eu parto às 6 horas. I departure at 6 o'clock. Tu dormes de tarde? Do you sleep in the afternoon? Ele, ela, você abre a porta. He or she opens the door. Nós dividimos tarefas. We divide or we share tasks. Tarefas means tasks. Eles, elas, vocês desistem. Desistir is vas getschmeck, ok? To give up. Rápido, quickly. Rápido is an adjective for quickly. So you will have, all of you, the chance to practice these different terminations, because there's only one way of memorizing them, which is to memorize them. So this sounds stupid, but it's true. It's like learning any language. In this case, you really have to memorize the terminations, how the different pronouns, how the verb changes according to the pronouns. And the best way to memorize is obviously to write, to repeat, to practice. So when do we use the presente do indicativo, verbos regulares? We saw that estar a mais infinitivo is to express actions right now, the things we are doing now. In the case of presente do indicativo, the simple past or Genish Zaman is to express, for example, estado permanente, a permanent state, a skill. So let me write it better. Estado permanente, a permanent capacidade, a skill, ok? Capacity and gostos, ok? Things we like. Preferences or things we like. Second situation, to indicate a usual action. To express a usual action. Things you do usually. Genellikle, ok? Things you do usually. Like, todos os dias, if you have these different expressions. Todos os dias, every day, habitualmente, generally, ao fim de semana, on weekends, or, for example, às segundas, on Mondays. I believe that previously I have shared the link with you in which there was a document with the different days and months. I can show it here again. If you don't have it, I can send it again. Okay, so the different, I've shared with you a document with the different days of the week and the months of the year. Okay, this will be important. This is important when you use the verbos regulares presente do indicativo. For example, to express things you do every Monday. Let's, for example, make a sentence using verb, regular verb, and to express a thing that we all do every Wednesday at 11. Nós temos aulas de português às quartas-feiras. Or às quartas, we can say just às quartas. Okay, so we are using a verb in presente do indicativo, the verbo ter, which means to have. Nós temos aulas de português às quartas. We have classes of Portuguese on Wednesdays. So, the key here is Wednesday, on Wednesdays. It means that it's an action that you have always or usually on that day. The third situation we use present to indicativo is curiously to indicate actions in a near future. Yakın gelecek zaman. Okay, in a near future, something that is almost certain. Followed or with expressions like amanhã, which means yarın, okay? Tomorrow. Para a semana, after ya, next week. Este sábado, this Saturday. Okay? So, this one, the first one you can practice at home, okay? And let's try to do now an exercise together by using this present do indicativo. Okay, so as you can see, you have here different verbs. They end in er, again, ir, er. Okay, so all of them are regular verbs, verbos regulares, presente do indicativo. Let's see the first case. Eles, they, then we have to use viver, okay, to live, numa casa alugada, in a rented house. Which one I have to put here? Eles, we have to go here and check what is the case for eles. What is the case for a verb in er? And the termination is em. So, eles vivem numa casa alugada. They live in a rented house. Now, what I want you to do is take 5 minutes and conjugate all these verbs. Then we can correct together, not with all of you, but with some of you. But please, all of you, right now, write the correct conjugation for all these verbs according to the person. If it's eu, ele, ela, eles, nós, whatever. You can check the board here because you obviously did not memorize it yet. And then we can see what the meaning of the sentence. So don't focus on the meaning of the sentence. You probably will not understand most of them, but the important thing is practice the conjugation. Practice to make the verb according to the person. Okay? Then I can tell you the meaning of those sentences. Okay, so it's 11:40 now until 11:45. Please proceed to write this sentences and then we can correct it together. Okay, 5 minutes. Ok, let's start. Vamos começar. Vamos começar. Let's start. I need 9 volunteers. Okay, so we have Eilem. We need 8 more.
We also have Birsen Hanım and Mustafa Bey.
Okay, 3.
Samet Bey.
4.
İrem Hanım.
5. We need 4 more. Seis. 6. Sete. 2 more. Then we can start. Come on, guys. Okay. We just need 1 more. I guess. Okay, let's start and then we will see if who wants to participate. Meniem, you can choose the order, okay? It's irrelevant.
Başak Hanım, buyurun. Başak Hanım, mikrofonunuzu açarsanız.
Hangisi Batu?
Başak Hanım.
Tamam. Duyuyor musunuz?
Evet, duyuyoruz.
Evet, duyuyoruz.
Eles, vivem, numa casa alugada. Eu e o filho moramos na residência universitária.
Muito bem. Muito bem, Bashak. Perfeito. Eu e o Phil, so it's me and Phil, so it's we, nós, moramos na residência universitária. We live, but in the sense of we, this live, this morar is like the Turkish oturmak. Viver is like yaşamak, okay? We talked about this, I think, on the first class. Live in a university residence. Muito bem, próximo, mais um, next one.
Bir selamın, buyurun.
Olá.
Olá.
Terceiro, Cristina apanha o metro todos os dias.
Muito bem. So, this Cristina, and then we have a coma here, which means in Portuguese this is called vocativo. It's like when we ask a question to someone, okay? So it's Cristina, okay? So we are calling her and then we make the question. Apanhas o metro todos os dias? So this apanhas, this form, it's for tu, okay? Tu apanhas o metro todos os dias. Do you get... Do you get, I told you before that apanhar, it's a verb we use for to take transportation. Do you take the metro every day? Okay, it's a question. Okay, next one.
Eylem Hanım, buyurun.
Okay, Paish do Tiago partem amanhã para
Bruxelas. Okay? just think of this X like this. Okay? Bruxelas.
Os pais do Tiago partem amanhã para Bruxelas.
Muito bem. Os pais do Tiago, Tiago's parents, departure, okay, partem, departure, tomorrow to Bruxelles, okay?
Can I ask a quick question about the pronunciation? For me, it's really hard to pronounce like this E-M at the end. How do you say, can you repeat one more time? Like partir, parte, partem, partem, how do you say that?
So it will be, for example, eu parto, okay? Tu partes. So this e, it's like this e. You read it like the Turkish e. Tu partes, okay? So it will be something like this.
Você parte, right?
Você, ele, ela, parte.
Parte.
Uh-huh. Ele, ela, parte. So the same, like the Turkish e. Then nós partimos. So this is the e, no problem.
Yeah.
Eles, elas partem. Em.
Partem.
The sound is em.
Partem.
Em. It's open. Okay. Muito bem. So, os pais do Tiago partem amanhã para Bruxelas. Próxima. Next one.
Sumeyra Hanım, buyurun.
Eşya agencia aluga quartos a estudiantes.
Muito bem. Esta agência, this agency, alugar is to rent, ok? To rent. Aluga, because it's it, ok? It's a agência, it's it. Esta agência aluga quartos, rooms, to students, a estudantes. Muito bem. Próxima. Next one.
Mustafa Bey, buyurun.
O Pedro e a Ana, program, é toda a hora.
Muito bem, Mustafa, bem. O Pedro e a Ana, ok? Pedro and Ana trocam, exchange, ok? They exchange messages, like text messages on the phone or on chat group, whatever, WhatsApp, whatever. Trocam mensagens, messages, a toda a hora. A toda a hora, it's like an expression. A toda a hora. It means all the time. Literally, it means every hour. But it doesn't mean that it has to be every hour. It's like an exaggeration. It means all the time. Like they are always on the phone, they are always exchanging messages, okay? All the time. A toda a hora. Próxima. Next.
Peri Hanım, buyurun. Perihan Hanım, buyurun. Okay, next one.
Duyabiliyor musunuz?
İrem, duyabiliyoruz.
Bu emir cümlesi mi? Bilemedim. Entende, Portuguese, mas, bir yanda. Entende, Portuguese mi? Hı-hı. Mas ainda não falo muito bem.
Okay. Periana, it's entendo. So it's eu entendo. Why do we know it's entendo? Because of the second verb. The second verb is falo. Okay, so you can see that it's a eu verb. It's eu. Okay, I, Ben. Entendo português, ok? Português de anliorum, mas, ama, heinus deil, ainda não means heinus deil, not yet. Mas ainda não falo muito bem. I cannot yet speak very well, ok? I understand, but cannot yet speak very well. So it's entendo. Next one.
Samet Bey, buyurun.
Vocês não dividem as tarefas de casa.
Vocês não dividem as tarefas de casa, ok? Just try to make a tonation of a question, ok? Because this is a question. Vocês não dividem as tarefas de casa? Ok, so it's a question, not an affirmative answer. So be careful with the tonation because, you know, it's like a question. So don't you divide the house tasks or the housework, okay? Don't you divide the housework. Muito bem. Próxima.
İrem Hanım, buyurun.
A que horas parto com o baio para Aveiro?
A que horas parte, muito bem, o comboio para Aveiro? A que horas, we will see the interrogativos, the way the pronouns to make questions, like the Turkish, neden, ne, nezaman, kaç, whatever, we will see them, I think, either on the next class or one class after, okay? So, but a que horas, it's cá está, okay? Or saat cá está. A que horas parte, what time does the train to Aveiro, Aveiro, it's a Portuguese city, between Porto and Lisbon, the train to Aveiro departures, okay? Partir, to departure. Última, last one.
Leão, não, buyurun.
Hoje, jantem, for, estamos fortes de concentrar.
Hoje, jantamos Fora, muito bem. Jantamos.
Jantamos.
Fora. Ok, so today, hoje, we have dinner out. Ok, fora means out, deixar de. Today we have dinner out. Estamos fartos de cozinhar. We are fed up of cooking. We are tired of cooking. Okay? So we don't want to cook at home. Today we have dinner out. That's what the sentence means. Questions about this? About any of the sentences, about the verbs, anything? You can speak if it's better, if you have questions. So everyone can also hear. You can also ask at the end of the class. It's also okay. So whatever you prefer, let us know. Okay, but if you have questions, it's better to speak. You can also ask in Turkish, okay? Don't worry. So that everyone can listen to the same question. Okay, so let's leave it for the last part of the class. Now, here we have, before we start the next exercise I want to do with you, here we have different images. The first set of images are actions. We have to connect them with these verbs. Okay, so chegar means to arrive, viver, morar. Okay, I told you it's this difference in Turkish between yaşamak, viver, oturmak, morar. But in English, to live. Trabalhar, çalışmak, to work. Apanhar, to take, in terms of take a transportation. Okay, so inmek, inmek, binmek, okay, to get a transportation. Estudar, ders çalışmak, to study. Okay, to study. So we have basically to connect them with the images. So I will do it. Let's not lose time with this. Estudar a. E, it's to work. D, chegar, to arrive. To take, C. And finally, to live, morar, B. And then we have different spaces. Okay, different spaces, generally to live. Okay, so quarto, it's a room, so it will be G. Casa, it's F. Apartamento, it's, wait a second, apartamento, E. Apartamento means apartment. Studio, it's a studio, so J, and finally residência universitária, university residence, so H. And then we have different means of transportation. Okay, ulaşım, metro, obviously it's E or L, not E. Avião, K. Comboio, train, is the O. Elétrico, the tram, is this M. And autocarro, autobus, or bus, it's N. So, knowing these verbs, these spaces and means of transportation, okay? So, verbos, espaços e transportes. Let me put it here. Verbos, espaços, spaces, and transportes, ulaşım. We need to complete the sentences following the example. Okay, so let's see the first. O Nilton é brasileiro, estuda, because we have the image for estudar, and we have to conjugate according to the person. O Nilton é brasileiro, estuda em Portugal e vive numa residência universitária. Okay? So, I will do one, and then the other, please complete at home. Okay? So, just for you to see the exam. o Daniel e a Rita, then we have this image that it's from apanhar, okay? To take transportation. But it's o Daniel e a Rita, which means eles, they. O Daniel e a Rita apanham, okay? Why it's apanham? Because it's verb apanhar in the eles, elas form. So they, eles apanham, ok? O Daniel e a Rita apanham o metro. Why o metro? Because this is the image for metro and o is the article for metro. Todos os dias, every day. E chegam, okay? This is the image for chegar, we have seen before, à escola, they arrive at school, às 8:30. Don't worry about this à escola, às 8. These are prepositions, prepositions of time or place. We will see them after, okay? Just for now. This is what the sentence means. So they take the metro every day and arrive at school at 8:30. The others, B, C e D, por favor, façam em casa. Please do it at home. Okay? So today we have seen the different verbs or different how to conjugate the verbs in ar, er and ir.